I was willing to give Red Pill Black the benefit of the doubt, and I was like, oh, we'll wait, see what it comes out. Maybe she has a better explanation for this. But the more this goes on, the more I think that she is a shill or something. Like, I just got blocked by her today on Twitter, and like, I'm not mad about that, but she's done this to a lot of people who are calling her out, especially about her lies concerning the splash page, that is bullshit, and just a few other inconsistencies, right? And the fact that she's bringing up identity politics and saying like, oh, I'm a black woman, it's so hard for me, etc. Like, she's slowly injecting this type of dialogue into conservative opinions or whatever, So it's like, I really do not trust this woman, and especially after she blocked me because I asked her questions, right? And just the shit she's saying, like, I covered in my other video before, but she's speaking, it's so cliche, the stuff that she's saying. It's like, oh, the liberals are the campaign against me, and these aren't true conservatives, and blah blah blah, and like, there's a few other things I gotta find, but like, it's so crazy to me how transparent this girl is, and the amount of people just eating this up is ridiculous. Like, I know, a lot of Trump supporters, etc., want to believe that she isn't a shill, etc., but the more she responds like this, the more she blocks people who ask her legitimate questions, the more I think that she is. And like I said before, I was gonna give her the benefit of the doubt, but after all this shit, it's like, no, not anymore. Because yeah, it's just, there's too many inconsistencies, right? And I'll look through. Hold on one sec. What? This is one of her latest tweets. What a beautiful coordinated attack, because the people are scared that the MAGA movement is growing with black conservatives. So, she's playing into you guys, right? Like, come on, man. Do you not see this? Like, she's just saying every line that she knows is gonna work on you guys, and you're all biting it. Fucking hook, line, and center. And this is why people believe conservatives are stupid, right? And she's gonna come out eventually as infiltrating the right? And she's gonna try to get a bunch of dirt on you, etc. And then all you people are gonna be like, oh my God, how could we? And they're gonna use this as an example of how stupid conservatives are, how easily it is to infiltrate them. Because all it takes is a person of color to say a few things, right? And then everybody shoots them up. Like, she was bitching that, oh, she has it so hard as a black conservative. Are you fucking serious? You've been on YouTube for a few months, and you've already shot past people who have been on there for years and years and years. It took you a few months to get to more than 150,000 subscribers, and you're complaining about the way people are treating you because of your race? Are you fucking kidding me? So yeah, a lot of the shit she's been saying is very suspect. And if this is not raising red flags for you, then you're just extremely biased. You don't want to see it, or you're stupid. You're a stupid person, and you're one of those same people who look at Laura Loomer, and Laura Loomer is even coming to her defense now and being like, oh, it's people like me and you that we have it so hard because of these fake conservatives, blah blah blah. It's like, no, these people are the ones infiltrating the movement and discrediting you. Every time these people, you give them a platform, etc., and say, oh, these are great people, they'll go and do some crazy shit. And you know who they're gonna blame? They're gonna blame you by proxy. You're gonna be like, well, you pushed her and she did all this shit. And it's like, all the stupid shit that Laura Loomer is doing, people see that and they apply that to conservatives. And all the shit that this girl's gonna be doing, they're gonna apply that to conservatives. So it's not a good idea. Do not give this girl any money, right? It's She could easily reopen, especially all the shady shit with the social autopsy thing and how she's just not answering direct questions. It's like, leads me to believe that she wouldn't be opposed to restarting that site again and posting people's information, because there was information on there tons of people's information. And she lied about that. She said it was just like a web page thing. It wasn't functional. These are all lies. And now she's saying there's an active campaign against her. It's fucking insanity. And she's playing into you guys. You know, she understands there are active campaigns that liberals do. You know, disinformation campaigns. These things exist, right? But she, you know, clearly she's not experiencing that, right? There are some liberals that came out and attacked her, like Jeff Holliday, etc. But a lot of conservatives that attacked her too are real, true conservatives, not fake like her. So, you know, I just see all these Trump supporters though supporting her. It's just boggling my mind, and it's like, you know, they're not going to do the research to see how this woman really is, and eventually she's gonna bite you guys. Like this is my prediction, and maybe I'm wrong. I hope I'm wrong. Honestly, if she just turns and she's actually not as regressive as she once was, and maybe she's just has some shitty personality traits, okay, right? But with the way she's handling this situation, makes me think that she is fucking lying and pretending. So yeah, just don't be surprised if she comes out and as an actual liberal pretending to be conservative. Just don't be surprised if that's the case. That's all I pretty much had to say. See ya.